Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I'm going to discuss the map of JavaScript. What is a map in JavaScript? It is just a collection of key value pairs. And in this video, I'm going to create a map, and I'm going to add some key value pairs to this map. After that, I can get a value by using the key, and I'm able to check whether a certain key exists in a given map. And I'm able to delete a value in a map by using the key. And I'm able to iterate a map. Also, I'm able to convert between an object and a map. Now, let us see the HTML file first. The HTML file is quite simple. I have a title and a heading. Also, the JavaScript file is linked to the HTML file. The file is called myscript.js, which is stored in the JS folder. And let me go back to the JavaScript file. In order to use the struct mode, I have to say use struct at the beginning of the JavaScript file. And now I can discuss the map. A map is just a collection of key and value pairs, and the keys here can be non-strings. Is it a bit abstract? I think so. So let me demonstrate this idea to you now. I have to create an empty map first. So I use the new map keyword to indicate that I'm going to create an empty map with no content inside, and the map is called my map. And after the creation of an empty map, I can really add some key value pairs to it. So this is the first element to include. The key is 999, which is an integer, and the value corresponding to this integer key is true, which is a boolean value. Now, this is the second element I would like to include in my map. The map now has two elements. The second one here has a string as the key and an integer as a value. Now the third element is like this. The boolean value called false is the key, and the value is a string called hello. And I can also say that the key can be other than integer, string, or boolean value. The keys can also be objects. So let me set up an object first. So now I have a simple object called car, and I just have one key value pair for this object. And then I want to set up the car as my key. So now the car object becomes my key, and the value corresponding to that object key is 2020, which is an integer. So you can see that I have 1, 2, 3, 4 objects by using the set command. Now, how can I get the value by using my key? I can demonstrate it to you now. The idea is to use the get method of the map. I want to get the value of this key, which is 999, as an integer. So you'll expect that I will get true. Is that the case? Let me see. Save. Reload. Yes, true has come out, because this is really the value corresponding to this key, 999, in integer form. So let me see another key value pair. Now, if the key is a string called 999, what will happen? Save. Reload. Yes, I will get 7 as the value coming from this string key, which is natural, okay? So now the false key should refer to this value called hello, which is a string. Save. Reload. Yes, hello has come out. So this is the value coming from this key called false. And what will happen if the key cannot be found from the map? Let me show you my demonstration right now. Now I don't have a key called true in my map, so you will expect that I will have some value corresponding to this situation. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see that the answer is undefined. So if a key cannot be found, the value would be called undefined. Okay. And if I want to show the size of a certain map, I can use the size method. Save. Reload. Yes, I have four elements. First one, second one, third one, and fourth one. So I have four elements in my map. And then I'm able to check whether a certain key exists or not in my map. I don't want to print the value corresponding to this key out, but I just want to see whether a key exists or not. So in this case, I can have a certain method called has. Does my map have this key called 999, which is an integer? My map has this key. So you will expect that the answer is positive. Save. Reload. Yes, it is true. This key really exists in my map. And how about another situation like this one? Does my map have this a key called true? No, so I would have false as this the answer. Save. Reload. Yes, I would get false. That is quite natural because I don't really have this key in my map. Now I'm going to tell you the way to do the deletion of the whole key value pair in my map. The idea is to specify the key and then I'm able to delete the whole key value pair. Now I want to delete the key value pair whose key is false. So in this case, I'm going to remove this key value pair in my map. So the false, which is a key, and the hello, which is a value, will be deleted. And how will I know the deletion? I just show the size of my map. Save. Reload. Yes, the size has been lowered to 3. So initially I had 4 key value pairs, but now I have just 3 because this one is already deleted. Now, in order to demonstrate more details of the map in JavaScript, let me set up another map. So now I have 3 key value pairs in my new map. So I just set up an empty map and then I do this addition by using the set method. And now I'm going to tell you the way to iterate the map elements by using the keys, values, or entries. So the entries here are just referring to the whole key value pair rather than just the separate key or the separate values. So when I do the iteration, the data will be shown according to the order of their insertion. Now the first example is to use the keys as the subject of iteration. So I use the keys method with a pair of parentheses after the keys keyword. And I also use a variable called sumKey. In this case, I'm able to obtain the keys according to the order of insertion. And then I can do the printing of all the keys one by one. Save. reload. Yes, A is the first key. B is the second key. And C is the last key. So by using the keys method, I'm able to do the iteration by keys. How about using the values as the subject of iteration? Let me show you my way. Now the idea is quite similar. Instead of using the keys method, I just use the values method. And I also let a variable called some value so that I can loop over all the values in my map. So I'm able to do the alert window for all of them. Save, reload. Yes, the first one to insert in the into the new map is AAA. The second one to insert is BBB. The final one to insert is CCC. So the order of insertion can be maintained during my showing using the alert window. Is it possible to show all the keys and values together? Yes, we can use the entries approach shown right now. Now I use the method called entries so that the key and value will be shown one by one. Save. Reload. Yes, the first key value pair is A and AAA. The second one is this one, B and BBB. The third key value pair is C and CCC. Okay. Is it possible to forget the use of keys, values, and entries after I mention my map? It is possible. If you do so, the entries method will be used by default. So let me see an example. Now you see that I don't include keys, values, or entries after my new map. So in this case, the entries method will be used by default. Save. Reload. Yes, I will see both the keys and values of my entries. The first one was shown. The second one is shown now. The third one is shown now. So you can see that the entries method is used by default if I don't mention it here. Okay. Next, I'm going to make a map from an object. What does it mean by this one? An object can consist of a number of key value pairs already. So is it possible to convert the key and value pairs in an object to those in a map? Yes, it is really possible. So let us see an example. Suppose I already have this object called vehicle. I want to put the key value pairs in the object to a certain map. So I can do something like this now. Now I use this sentence to show that I want to make a map by using the vehicle object listed above. Object.entries is a built-in method in JavaScript that helps us to convert a certain object to a map. And the map content is based on this object.entries method. Now, if I really want to print out the content in my map called vehicle map by using the key, I can do something like this. I just use the alert window in this way and the get method in this way. Save, reload. Yes, the first alert window shows that the value corresponding to the type key is just a bus. And the value corresponding to the color key is green. Okay, so this is the way to convert a map to an object. Is it possible to do it in another direction? Yes, it is possible. So in this case, I just make a map first, and then I want to convert a map to an object. When I want to make a map, I can use another idea. The idea is like this. A map can be initialized by collecting some key value pairs into my declaration directly. So this is my new way to set up a map. So this is my map. I can already put the content of my map into the map keyword. So you can see that I have two key value pairs. The first key value pair has Peter as the key and 16 as the value. The second key value pair has Sandy as the key and 15 as the value. So in this case, I don't really have to create an empty map before I really put something into my map. I can initialize a certain new map by putting the contents of the map immediately. And then I can do the conversion from a map to an object. The idea is to use the object.fromEntries method given by JavaScript. And then I just put the map into this method and the object will come out. Okay, if I want to obtain the value corresponding to these two keys, what will happen? Let me see. Save. Reload. Yes, I can get 16 as the value corresponding to this key called Peter. And the second value is 15, which corresponds to the key called Sandy. So we can do the conversion between a map and an object in both directions. So this video has already talked about so many ways to handle a map. We know the way to set up a map, which starts from an empty map, and then I just add key value pairs to it. And then I can get the value of a map by using the key. And I can check whether a key exists or not. And I can do the deletion of the whole key value pair by indicating the key. Also, I can do the iteration of the content of my map. I can also do the conversion between a map and an object, finally. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.